National Public Radio with us, Click and Clack, the Tappet Brothers, and we're here to discuss cars, car repair, and of all things, foreign aid.
Yes, and this comes to us by way of the news desk.
Beep, 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 beep,
beep, beep, buddy, I believe, by looking at all the to's and from's here, George Preston. Here's the news. Clinton deploys vowels to Bosnia. Cities of Zbrzeznik and Grozny to be the first recipients. Before an emergency joint session of Congress yesterday, President Clinton announced U.S. plans to deploy over 75,000 vowels to the war-torn region of Bosnia.
Really?
The largest of its kind in American history, will provide the region with the critically needed letters A, E, I, O, and U, and is hoped to render countless Bosnian names more pronounceable. Here's a quote. He said, Clinton said, for 6 years we've stood by while names like Jugoslav and Zlidnia and Glum have been horribly butchered by millions around the world. Today, the United States must finally stand up and say, enough. It is time the people of Bosnia finally had some vowels in their incomprehensible words. The U.S. is proud to lead the crusade in this noble endeavor. The deployment, named Operation Vowel Storm by the State Department. Who writes this stuff? I mean, it is much needed.
It's set
for early next week with the Adriatic port cities of Zbrzeznik and Grozny. The two C-130 transport planes, each carrying 524 count boxes of ease. We'll fly from Andrews Air Force Base across the Atlantic and airdrop the letters over the cities. The citizens of Grozny and Zbrzeznik eagerly await the arrival of the vowels. My God, I don't think we can last another day, said Zbrzeznik. Said Trushki Grozny. I have 6 children and none of them has a name.
None of them a vowel among them.
Said Zimbabwean resident Grugs. With just a few key letters, I could be George Humphrey. This is my dream. The airdrop represents the largest deployment of any letter to a foreign country since 1984. During the summer of that year, the U.S. shipped 92,000 continents to Ethiopia, providing cities like Awawua, Ayolia, and Ao with vital life-giving supplies of L's, S's, and T's.
I'm sure we will hear letters of complaint from the international community. Yes, indeed.
It's great.
But it's all true. I mean, it's like the weekly world news. I mean, it's not a false statement
not
there.
Not a false statement there. That's very clever.
All right, it's time. 2278255. Hello, you're on Car Talk.
Hi, this is Gail from South Philadelphia, Pennsylvania.
Gail from where?
South Philadelphia.
South of Philadelphia, Pennsylvania.
Oh, not South Philadelphia, but south of.
Well, no, South Philadelphia.
South Philadelphia.
Same as Bill Cosby.
Yes, exactly. He went to Temple University here.
Yeah, he did.
Yes, he did. Which one is Click and which one's Clack?
Yes. So what can we do for you?
The guy on the right is Click.
Oh, okay, I thought so. Okay, I have a little problem here in Philadelphia. I feel like I'm sort of a fugitive of sorts here. My friends Jonathan and David told me to call you and that you might be able to help. Okay, mm-hmm. I drive a teal, 1991 Saturn, which you'll need to know later, okay?
1991 Saturn.
Yes. And, okay, I take a bridge to work every day, and they charge $2 to get across this bridge. Okay, that's a little pricey, but I have to take it. So I have my $2 ready, and I'm waiting in a tow line that's 15 cars long or something. And at the last minute, I realize that I'm in a coins-only lane, and there's no way to get across the traffic.
And you start shredding the dollars, right?
Exactly. I had no choice of what to do. With this short notice, I had no way of pulling this kind of cash together, so... I realized that it was also a toll lane where one of those arm things comes down, so it's not like I can just go through it.
Ah, so you're going to have to run the rapids, as they say.
Exactly.
Shoot the rapids.
Exactly.
When the guy in front of you, the other guy's green light.
Yeah.
So I waited until the guy in front of me threw in his, whatever, 300 quarters or whatever, and when that arm thing went up, I floored it. I went through it. Buzzers went off. There was mayhem everywhere.
Did you make it?
No one followed me, though.
You made it under, though.
I was very lucky. I don't know how I did it, but I made it under.
Well, you've obviously discovered one of the best kept secrets in the world. Who was there to chase you?
Nobody.
Nobody.
No, of course not. My question is, do they take a picture of my license plate? Is there some way that I could, like, send the $2 in? Because I don't want them to send something to my house because my husband's going to be so mad.
So you have a guilty conscience about this.
I really do, but I don't want to get caught in the I'm honest and then they're going to charge me $40 for doing this.
Right.
You know?
You may, in fact, be opening a Pandora's box by confessing to the crime.
Exactly.
You may be subjecting yourself to a toll evader's fine. So they'll take the $2 from you, and then they'll come to your house and arrest you. Here's what I would do.
Okay.
I would let sleeping dogs lie.
Yeah. Okay.
I mean, if you really feel some compunction to pay up, if the toll is $2, the next time you get in line, and for the next 8 times you get in line, throw 9 quarters in.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, okay.
It will never penalize you. It'll never not send the gate up. It'll figure you're another stoop that just put in too much money.
Right.
The gate will go up, and within 2 months you will have satisfied your conscience. You'll have satisfied the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania.
Well, will they come get me? Is there any way they can get my address for my license plate?
What bridge is it? We can find out.
It's called the Betsy Ross Bridge.
Oh, it's
95.
Okay. Well, we are trying to reach the Pennsylvania Transportation Authority.
Okay.
Huh?
Okay.
Was it Delaware?
Oh, no, Pennsylvania. Oh. Coming from New Jersey into Pennsylvania.
Into Pennsylvania. So the bridge is actually in Pennsylvania.
From New Jersey to Pennsylvania.
Oh, yeah. No, it's in New Jersey.
It's a bridge over between the two states.
Oh, so both states
will
be after you.
Oh, it's the federal government then. It's a federal job.
It's a federal offense.
So I don't know.
Okay, it seems to be run by the Delaware Port Authority.
Okay.
I don't know why.
Because it's over the Delaware River, maybe.
We have him on the phone? You've got to be kidding me.
Oh, my God.
You're not
going to
believe
this.
Hold on a minute. We're not giving him your name.
Okay.
Evidently, Doug and Ken have just somehow gotten a hold of who? Dawn, somebody who's the bridge manager.
Hello, Dawn.
Hello, Gail. Gail,
oh, this is cruel.
Oh, my goodness. I really was ready to pay the $2, and I didn't
get
the
change.
Gail, we chased you for 4 miles. Stop.
No, wait a minute. Dawn, who are you really, Dawn?
I'm the bridge manager at the Betsy Ross Bridge.
You really are?
I really am.
Oh,
if we don't get this $2 fast, we might have to close this bridge up.
Oh, my God.
No, but for other people who might want to try what Gail did, do you take pictures?
We do surveillance of the toll plaza. Do we take specific pictures? I am not at liberty to tell you.
You're not at liberty to tell us. But the truth is that you could probably get through.
If that gate came down on Gail's car, Lord knows the destruction it would have caused.
No, actually, the
gates are made of a breakaway wood. We wouldn't want to damage anyone's car.
Mm-hmm. Oh,
I would not encourage anyone to try to do that. We do patrol our plaza with our own police force, and we do pursue toll evaders. And just for your information, the toll evasion fine is not $40, but more like $200.
Oh, Gail, you're going to the slammer.
I don't think Gail wants to get herself in trouble.
No.
So, no, and Gail probably doesn't want Dawn to know even her last name.
No, of course not.
Right?
But look, how about this, Dawn? If Gail sends the money to us and we send it to you anonymously in the name of Gail, Gail Anonymous, then she'll be off the hook, right? And you won't know who she is and she will not incriminate herself. Is that okay with you?
That sounds good to me, but Gail is not on my good side to begin with for calling my bridge toll a little pricey.
No! I mean, that's a lot.
How long a bridge is it, Dawn? How long is this bridge?
Try New York bridges. $7 a shot.
Oh.
Yeah, that's true.
This bridge is, how long is it, Dawn? I mean, it's, you know, 300
Are there any trolls underneath the bridge?
It's 1.75 miles over the river. But if you don't use it, Gail, how are you going to get back into Pennsylvania?
I don't know.
Maybe she doesn't want it.
Why do you have to have a coins-only lane?
Well, we do have some to service patrons who have a commutation sticker on their window.
I don't think they're marked very well, Don, because I didn't see it until the last minute. Well,
kind of feisty for a lawbreaker, isn't she?
Yeah. I mean, hey, Gail.
Yes.
Cool it up. I got to give him your name.
And by the way, Gail, there is no statute of limitations on this. We can find you.
Hey, Dawn, thanks a lot for letting us find you. I don't know how we found you, but it's good to know.
You're welcome. I'm looking forward for that $2 to arrive in the mail.
All right, you will get it. Don't worry.
Oh, definitely.
And if you don't get it, chase us for it, buddy.
Thank you very much.
Thanks a lot.
Thanks.
Thank you, Gail.
Okay, thanks a lot.
Hey, wait a minute.
Okay.
Make sure you send us the money.
Yeah, you don't think we're going to pay this $2, do you? And in fact, you might want to send in extra in case, you know, there's a penalty or anything.
An extra $200.
Yeah, yeah. Postage and handling and all that. It might be like $22.50. Yeah.
And you might want to include a little something to make sure we don't divulge your last name.
Oh, okay.
You know,
yeah.
Baked
point.
Goods are always good.
See you, Gail.
Hey, Gail, you're a good sport.
Thanks.
You were a little feisty with the guy, though.
Well, he was being mean.
Well, I think $2 is actually pretty reasonable for a bridge. I mean, bridges are hard to build.
Yeah,
how do they build bridges? You have land on one side, land on the other side, and water in the middle.
Batman, you know the thing he shoots across?
Oh, that's right. So I guess $2 isn't bad, but...
It's not bad because the alternative is to be in New Jersey.
Yes.
Yeah, let's not forget that.
So.
There you go. So.
Okay.
Thanks for calling,
Gail. Thanks a lot.
And carry some quarters, will you?
I will.
Bye.
Bye.
That was good. You're going to love this.
I'm sure I will.
This is from Andy Reichman from Marlboro, Vermont, 05344. Dear Click and Clack, I'm writing to offer profound thanks to you for resolving an important philosophical question that has been heatedly debated for the last 20 years.
Really?
Get this now. The rumination began on a construction site one summer in the early 70s as my best friend Jamie and I were working our way through college. The question we raised and have agonized over lo these many years is one that I have never read about in any philosophical treatise, and yet I have found it has applied to countless situations and conversations overheard in bars, repair shops, sporting events, political debates, etc., etc. Posit the question. Do two people who don't know what they're talking about...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.